I live not far from Herndon, so I hear the racing too. And then we had, of course, the tragedy on December 26th. And even with having PD out there trying to stop this person chose to evade and killed three innocent people. So we really need to make our presence known. But for me, when residents speak up, I want them to know their city and their police department is going to respond.
We're here to kind of, honestly, take back the streets. We're here to remind people that you got to be very, very careful driving. Something that weighs 2,500, 3,000 pounds that's going 60 miles an hour. More likely to hurt in significant ways people with a car than a firearm or anything else. So we want to remind people that. We have a fixed-wing aircraft that we're using tonight that has very, very good optics on it. So we can see things from a higher elevation. That acts as a pointer system. We also have video downlink capability, so we can see what's going on at the time. We also have UAVs or drones in the area, so we can deploy those as well. And then finally, we have a helicopter. So we don't want to get in the pursuit. We don't want to ramp up the danger factor of this thing. But we do have aircraft that can follow those to a location, and then we can safely take them into custody. This is the tip of the iceberg. This is just the beginning. What we want people to understand is this is a priority for the city of Fresno. Public safety is. And so we're going to be out here a lot. Same groups, same operational scheme, same thing, varying the hours, the dates, and the times. We want to make sure that people understand we're here for their safety, and then we're going to take enforcement action.
I can tell you that this police department that we have is very data-driven, and they're going to move this operation wherever it needs to go. And our goal is, get them out of Fresno. You want to race? Don't do it here.